Save my soul, lost in a shadow, need a miracle. Locked in a battle, I was on my own, living in yesterday. Yeah. Take it all the way.
Good morning, Wolfpack. I'm Alex Carl.
And I'm Caleb Farnetti, and we're here with your morning announcements.
I'm Promise, and this is Brady. We'll be back later in the show with your sports update.
In school news, this week the student store will be closed. So if you need to purchase anything, go to the controller window after school.
Food fair is tomorrow. Remember to bring money this Friday so you can purchase a wide variety of meals ranging from Costco pizza to boba popcorn chicken.
This Friday is our Ugly Sweater Spirit Day, so show off your best bad sweater.
If you want to be updated on school events and activities, add the COHS event Snapchat account.
The next monthly pathway meeting is next Wednesday, December 13th from 6:30 to 7:30 in the MP room. This is an opportunity to gather resources for college preparation.
Seniors, if you are a Term 3 AP Comparative Government student, please visit the library this week to check out your textbook. Bring your student ID card and visit before or after school or during lunch. Feel free to visit Mrs. Lalonde next week for a Term 3 pacing calendar.
Now let's send it over to Promise and Brady for your sports update.
Thanks, guys. How's it going, everybody? Let's get right into your sports update with basketball. Last week, we went and took a look at the men's varsity team, and we're bringing you the highlights. First, we have Terrell Garner-Bennon passing to Greg Milton, who makes the shot. Next, we have senior Nohia Roberts as he makes the layup. Then we have Nohia again with a very nice steal as he and Greg take it down the court with Nohia making the final point. Finally, we have sophomore Malachi Hartman who makes a nice pass to junior Jordan Lewis.
They had three more games last week. On Thursday, the team went up against McClatchy and won 69-36. On Friday, they went against Elk Grove and won 61-54. Finally, on Saturday, the team went up against St. Mary's, but unfortunately lost 57-41. And for women's basketball, the varsity team had a home game against Lathrop on Tuesday and won with a score of 57-27. They're doing amazing so far, so make sure to come out today to their neutral tournament here at COHS starting at 7 p.m. Play hard, ladies.
Moving on to men's varsity soccer, the team had an away game against Grant on Tuesday and won with a score of 4-0. They'll be playing a home game against Franklin starting at 6 p.m. tomorrow. Good luck, Wolfpack.
The women's varsity soccer team has also won their game up against Elk Grove with a score of 3-0. The team will be playing a home game against Franklin tomorrow at 4 p.m. Make sure to come out and show your support.
If you're interested in being a part of the swimming and diving team for the 2018 season, there will be an open house this Wednesday, December 6th from 4 to 6 p.m. at the Sunshine Swim and Fitness Center pool. See below for the pool's address.
All boys interested in playing on the COHS golf team this spring need to attend an informational meeting today, right after school, in HD7. If you are unable to make the meeting but would like information, contact Coach Milgram in HD7, first or second period each day.
That's all we have for you today, Wolfpack. Let's send it right on back to Caleb and Alex for the rest of your announcements.
In club news, Vex Robotics had a competition last Tuesday. Let's see how it went.
Vex Robotics had a competition last Tuesday. We caught up with Mrs. Hale, the club advisor, to see how the team did.
Competition went pretty good. We earned 7th out of 30.
The team is not deterred by their placing, and they acknowledge that there is still room for improvement.
Sometimes not everyone is able to get together at the same time, and so it makes it a little bit more difficult to put together a game plan when you have multiple minds going in different directions. We're working on an autonomous portion of our code, so the robot would be able to run a pre-programmed code to be able to score points in the beginning.
If you are interested in competing as well, come by Mrs. Hale's room, HF2, Thursdays after school for more information.
Attention FBLA members, tomorrow is the end of the year social. Will be after school in the culinary building from 3:15 to 4:30 p.m. There will be food, fun, and information, so be sure to attend.
Tech applications for the spring musical Thoroughly Modern Millie are available in Ms. Chun's room, HE5, or on the Wolfpack Performing Arts blog. To apply, you need experience working on a build or running crew for any theatrical production. Get your application in before winter break if you'd like to be a part of the management team.
Today is the last day you can sign up for the Red Cross Blood Drive. You can sign up at the tables during both lunches. The actual blood drive will take place Monday, December 11th.
Attention all NHS inductees. Induction practice will be held on Tuesday, December 12th, right before the ceremony. Be in the PAC at 4:30. The ceremony will start at 6 p.m. Parents will be admitted starting at 5:30.
Last week, our crew checked in with the culinary department. Let's see what they've been up to.
Hi, my name is Dejanay Robinson, and yesterday I had the experience of sharing my pop-up restaurant with a few of the teachers around campus. The pop-up restaurant is basically, at the beginning of the term, we had to come up, everybody in the class had to come up with different restaurant concepts and a different menu. And my menu was liked by three of the executive chefs, so I got picked.
Chef Garibaldi, and this is Dejanay Robinson.
Hi.
And we're pretty excited that everything went very smoothly with Ma's Kitchen, which was her restaurant pop-up. In our marketing and leadership class, the students had prepared their own original restaurant ideas. It was a full project that entailed marketing plans, their restaurant layout of back of house and front of house. They put together all the ideas for interior as well as menu planning, which is a very important part. And we had this really awesome opportunity to launch it. Dejanay's project was one of the projects that we selected as a class to launch, and it was incredibly successful. Would you agree?
Yeah, I liked it a lot. It was a great experience, and I actually got like a lot of training from Chef and a lot of the other culinary teachers around, so I felt like it was all over good experience.
Well, that's all we have for you today, Wolfpack. I'm Caleb Farnetti.
And I'm Alex Carl. Remember, the strength of the pack is the wolf.
And the strength of the wolf is the pack.